So this brings us to test two. We're going to need some kind of reliable way to tell if molecules that aren't rings are chiral or not. And we know that the internal line of symmetry test, or what I call test one, is crap for chains and branches and stuff like that. So we're going to need some kind of test, okay? And it turns out I have just the thing for you guys. What we're going to talk about now is called stereocenters, okay? So it turns out there's another test that we can use, and this test is actually going to be the gold standard for most molecules, okay? So it might be a little bit harder to use in some kinds of molecules, but it's going to work every time, okay? How does it work? Well, we have to define what is a stereocenter. A stereocenter is any atom that creates a stereoisomer after swapping groups. And that is called, like I said, a stereocenter, okay? So what is that definition? Basically, what I'm trying to say here is that if you swap atoms, any two atoms on the same carbon, if you swap their position, and if you wind up getting a different molecule or a molecule that has a different shape afterwards, that is called a stereocenter. So here I've given you two different examples. In this first example, I went ahead and I had a bromine in the front, and then I swapped it with an H in the back. And what we'll notice is that now the H is in the front and the bromine is in the back. This is a type of stereocenter because after I inverted these two groups, I didn't get the same exact molecule. In one of them, the bromine is in the front. In the other one, the bromine is in the back. Since there's no plane of symmetry here, those are actually different molecules. Okay? Another example would be like this ring. How this ring here has a methyl in the front and an H in the back. Okay, and after I swap those two groups, the methyl goes to the back and the H goes to the front. Those are also, those are going to be also different molecules because once again, we have a ring and rings can't rotate easily. So that means if it's on the front, it's going to stay on the front. If it's on the back, it's going to stay on the back. So this would also be an example of what we call a stereocenter. The stereocenter itself is the atom or the group of atoms that it's attached to. Okay.